rows you have almost all the chapters. So the adventure of learning, unit 1, and the text say Memories of CrossKid Schools by George Orwell. George Orwell is a very famous prose writer, and George Orwell Animal World is very it's a satirical book on politicians. It's a very good book, and you can it is a drama, and you can go for it. It's a very good book. So George Orwell, he was a very famous prose writer, and how he has been in his school days, and what he has in memories when he was in school, he has described in this unit. So Memories of CrossKid School. I have good memories of CrossKid among a horde of bad ones. He has so many good memories of CrossKid. CrossKid is a school where he was studying, and so many good memories he has, and among a horde of bad ones. Horde means bulk, means so many. Among so many bad ones, he has so many good memories also. So in school you have good memories also and bad ones also. So it is a combination of two, day also, night also. So sometimes on summer afternoons, there were wonderful expeditions across the downs or to Beachy Head. So he says, sometimes in summer days, during the afternoons, when he had, usually they go for expeditions, on adventurous expedition, across the downs. Downs means a stretch of grasslands, okay, a meadow type. So they usually have their expeditions. They go many of the times there, and that also in the afternoons. Or to Beachy Heads. Beachy Head means beach. So where the sea flows, and where they, that places also they used to go there. Where one bad dangerously. And so don't think that how you have the beach in Puri, it's not exactly the same type of beach in foreign countries, especially in European countries. If any of you have gone to Bombay, you might have seen how the, in the Arabian Sea, how the so many this bulk of rocks are there, and how the sea flows over there. Okay, so among that chunk boulders are there, many very big boulders are there, and big rocks or cliffs are there, and among that the usually the sea water flows. In European countries also it is the same. Underneath so many bulk of these rocks are there, it can be found. Okay, so what they do, so in the summer afternoons they used to go to the beach or go to the grasslands, and there were bad dangerously. So among these rocks they usually take their bath among the chalk boulders, and came home covered with cuts. And what happens when they take bath in the sea, they have so many cuts in their hands, feet, their legs, and the body also. So many cuts they were formed. And there were still more wonderful midsummer evenings when, as a special treat, we were not driven off to bed as usual, but allowed to wander about the grounds in the long twilight, ending up with a plunge into the swimming bath at about 9 o'clock. So don't think that summer days, especially in European countries, the sunset usually at 9 or 10 o'clock at night. So here it is night, and after 6 we have the days over. Okay, daylight is gone, but there it is not the same. Understood? So there what happens, because of the European countries are very near to the northern pole, and especially during summer days, the sun shines very brightly and sets at near about 9 o'clock. That is why he says, They used to have their summer in the afternoons. They go to the vigilance and they usually go to the towns also. And what about the evenings? How it was? So if it is so, the question is being asked how they spend their summer afternoons, you can say they usually go to the beachy heads and downs also, where they usually take their bath and they have their cuts in their whole of the body, and it is bleeding also excessively. And there is still more wonderful midsummer evenings. And how their evenings were? Very special thing. Usually they have a very special things. What happens in the evening? They have a very special treat. We were not driven off to bed as usual. They were not never driven off to bed. They were not driven off to bed immediately at 9 o'clock that you should go to bed. But rather what happens? But allowed to wander about the grounds. Rather they were allowed to move about in the grounds in the long to light. Okay, in the evenings means it is usually the dusk time where the night comes and the day goes away. And this twilight is very long, especially in European countries. Ending up with a plan. And what they usually do? They just have a dive into the swimming bath at about 9 o'clock. Okay, where it is night here, 9 o'clock means it is evening there. That is why their twilight is very long. There was the joy of waking early on summer mornings. This is evening. Evening they usually plunge into bathing tub. And in summer mornings what they do? They usually get up early and getting in. And summer mornings and getting in an hour's undisturbed reading. And they usually what do? They get up early in the morning and they go for reading. Reading about authors. Okay, who all the authors are? Ian Hay, Thackeray, Kipling, H.G. Wells were the favorite authors of my boyhood. And these are the greatest novelists of the 19th century ever lived. So these are the famous names of 19th century prose or novel writers. They were very good, and some of them, H.G. Wells, he had received Nobel Prize for Literature also. So they were his favorite. Ian Hay, Thackeray, Kipling, they were his favorites, okay? And they usually for have a 1 hour undisturbed reading in the sunlight, sleeping dormitory. Dormitory is a place where so many students, attestants, they sleep at one place. It's called dormitory, okay? So many students, they sleep. And so many, it may be 11 students, it may be 6 students, it may be, it's a long place, okay? So where they usually used to have their bed and they sleep there. So there was also cricket. So in the morning what they used to do? They used to read. And his favorite, and that also used to read who? The favorite novelist. And they usually have also, they usually play cricket also. Which I was no good at. But George Orwell, he was not at all good in cricket, nor he was very much interested in it. But with which I conducted a sort of hopeless love affair up to the age of about 18. Means he is not at all interested in cricket. He just have as if he loved, as if he used to play without love for it. He doesn't like it. Rather, he just move about and just have to play cricket. Just everyone used to play. That's why he used to play. But he doesn't have a love for it. So many students are there, and they love cricket too. And so many others, they love to read. So many others, they love to see. In that way, George Orwell, he never had a love for it. Rather, he plays, but he doesn't have a love. So, and there was the pleasure of keeping caterpillars. And what he was interested? He was not interested for cricket. He was interested, and he has a pleasure of keeping caterpillars, the silky green, the purple wash moth, the ghostly green, popular hawk, the prefect hawk, A largest one-third finger, specimens of which could be illicitly purchased for 6 pence at a shop in the town. So these are these caterpillars, silk, green, these are sorts of insects. And which, what he did, George Will? He used to keep them as his pet. And what he did, another thing, what he did, they were not allowed to keep all these things with them. But what George Will did, he went to the town and from the shop, he used to pay 6 pence and illicitly, means he's not allowed, he is not at all allowed by the superintendent of his hostel, that rather he used to go there and that also secretively, and he used to purchase all these things and keep it with him. And when one could escape long enough from the master who was taking the walk, there was the excitement of reaching the due points on the downs for anonymous news with and one could escape long enough. So why they used to do? What is the reason for this? He used to say that why he was going to the town and illicitly why he was purchasing all these things and that also at 6 pence in a town. Why? What is the reason? So this is taking the walk long enough from the master. So they want to go away from the master who taking the walk, means the master was actually, he keeps on walking, but he keeps a watch over the boys on the pretext of taking the walk. So that is the reason. So he usually move on and he usually walk on, but in the pretext, he wanted to see what these boys are doing. And there was the excitement of dredging the dew ponds on the downs. And dredging the dew ponds means small natural ponds they used to move there. And they, what they did there? They used to catch small mews, means moleskin. Moles means frogs or small animals type. So they used to catch them. And for anonymous newts, means newts means small animals with orange colored bellies. They had orange colored bellies, the insects, they used to catch them. This business of being out for a walk, coming across something of fascinating interest and then being dragged away from it by the elf from the master like a dog jerked onwards by the leash. Means he says that the business of being out for a walk, they usually go out and that too also secretively they used to go out for a walk. And what happens? Coming across something of fascinating interest, whichever you have a very fascination, means when you go for a movie, which you have a very fascination for the movie. But if your parents, they by chance they comes to know that you have just bunk your classes and you have gone to see a movie, then what they will do? They immediately move out to the theater and they will just pull you out. You just imagine what will be your condition. It is also the same condition. They go out, very rarely they go out, and if sometimes they go out also and they have a fascination for something, their love for something, which they have a interest for something, but they are being just pulled out, that he says, like a dog jerked onwards by the leash. Means if a dog just it is moving somewhere and you just pull it out, no, you please come here, you don't move that side. In that way, like a dog jerked onwards by the leash is an important feature of school life. So it is a very important. You want to do something which has a lot of interest for you, but what you do? At that time, when you have a fascination, you have an interest, but your teachers, but your parents, they never allow you to do it. So it is the same condition and helps to build up the conviction. And what idea? You conviction means idea, and helps to build up the conviction means idea. So strong in many children, so in many children, what idea they have, what feelings they have, that the things you most want to do are always unattainable. So whatever you want to do, whatever you have the interest for something, you are not allowed to do it. And what is your condition and what you have? You hate your teachers, you hate your parents at some of the time in your life, that means school days. Whatever you want, what interests you, that you are not allowed to do. And what you have the feelings? These people, they never want us to go forward. That is why you never allow them. You have the feelings for your parents. You have the feeling for your teachers. You have the feeling for others, those whoever just pull you out. At that time, you have an idea, you make your mindset that these people, they never allow us to do whatever we have the interest for. Understood? So this is about how these memories of Prescott School, George Orwell, he has gone through it. And whatever he speaks, how he spends his summer days, summer afternoons, how he spends his summer evenings, and how, what are the things they used to do, what are the they love to do, but when they are not allowed by the teachers to do. And these, and very interesting is, these are the things which you do secretively, but what happens? But you are not allowed to do it. There is some limit for everything. You cannot go beyond that. That is the thing. That is why your parents, your teachers, they never allow you to do it. So these are the memories of Prescott schools. Understood? So please try to answer the questions. And one thing I'll tell you, I'm not going to give you any questions answer for it, because this is alternative English and you have to write it yourself. If you write it yourself, then only you can go forward. Otherwise, it is very difficult. Understood? So please refer the book. Then you answer the questions. If you don't understand, you please call me up or give the message. Then, but name for, I don't expect that I am going to give you the answer. If you don't know the answer, it's okay. You can ask me in your phone. But name for, I am not going to, don't expect that I am going to give you the answers. English, it is okay for other students are there. That's why I am giving you the answers. But for alternative English, I am not going to give you the answers. You have to write it yourself. Please refer the book and write the questions and answers yourself. Understood? So I think poetry also the same thing. I have just given you, you write the question answers yourself. Ecology, this also you write it yourself. Okay? Okay, if you don't understand, please ask me. I'll tell you.